What's up guys, it's BT here and this is a review of the Benq EW3270U 32-inch 4K HDR monitor with 10-bit. That was a mouthful, and rightfully so, because this VA panel is definitely packed with a lot of amazing features, whether you're a gamer or a content creator, which I am both, so this monitor has definitely been a joy to use. The EW3270U is definitely a jack of all trades, and it comes in at around $500 at the time of this review, which is something you don't really see for a 4K HDR 10-bit panel with 60Hz and FreeSync and 95% coverage of the DCI-P3 wide color gamut. So right off the bat, it is checking a lot of boxes and it's making my mouth really tired talking to you guys about it. So let's start off with the design of this monitor. It's a 32-inch monitor and it is massive. The monitor comes with a monitor stand, which is nice, but it doesn't have any swivel capabilities and can only have a 5 to 15 degree tilt. I really wish that there was a little bit more movement with this stand, but since this is a VA panel, I understand why they did it, as you want to be looking at VA panels straight on to get the best picture quality. I also wish there was like a height adjustment to give more flexibility with positioning depending on your desk height. The bezels are nice and thin, which I love, so if you want to run like a dual monitor setup, these would actually work out really nicely for you. On the back, you'll find two HDMI 2.0 ports, a 1.4 display port, and USB-C ports. You can connect the USB-C device to this monitor like a MacBook Pro, but it can't charge your laptop simultaneously like some other monitors can. It's strictly just for a picture connection, guys. On the bottom side, the power button lights up, and there's also some monitor controls down there on the bottom. On the front of the monitor, you'll find the HDR button to turn it on or disable the HDR and BI Plus modes. The HDR hotkey gives you 4 levels of HDR with BenQ's exclusive Opt Clarity technology. This will sense your environment and adjust the monitor's HDR to give you the best picture quality for your environment. And I feel like it works like a charm. I'm somebody that kind of edits in like a smaller dim lit environment, so I like that it's able to just sense my surroundings and give me the best, most accurate picture quality when I'm like color grading these videos. In the menus, you'll find the eye care settings, picture settings, which you can only change the sharpness when HDR is on. There's also a picture advanced mode, which lets you choose the picture mode. I think there are some great modes in there, like the photo and the standard modes, which give you some great blacks for video and photo editing. Most of the time though, I was using the HDR because I wanted that amazing vibrancy. Now this monitor does have speakers, you can adjust the volume, but I wouldn't recommend it in most situations because they just don't get that loud for movie or music listening. I usually never use monitor speakers anyways, even if my monitor does have them, so this is nothing new to me. Overall though, it's got the screen size, it's got the modes, it's got the slim bezel, so let's take a look at the panel itself and see how it performs. Out of the box, the monitor is factory calibrated and the colors were actually pretty good, but I went ahead and just calibrated it with my Spider 5 Pro, as I do with all my monitors, because I want my monitor to be as accurate as possible when I'm color grading these videos. I had this monitor next to my ultra wide IPS monitor and it looked almost the same. VA panels are known for having more contrast, which makes your pictures and videos look even sharper than on, let's say, an IPS panel. And with all panels, you know, there are some good panels and there's some really bad panels. There's some really good TN panels and there's some really bad IPS panels, and all vice versa every which way. So it really depends on the actual quality of the monitor and the panel that they are giving you. And this is a great panel. There is some backlight bleeding around the edges, but not too bad. I think my Alienware monitor actually has more backlight bleeding than this. This monitor is also HDR compatible, and if you aren't familiar with HDR, it stands for High Dynamic Range, which allows greater range of luminosity while viewing movies and like content. So you get greater detail in the shadows during like movies and gaming. So let me tell you guys, this monitor just blew me away, and that is coming from somebody that's been using a 1440p ultra wide monitor. This is my first 4K monitor and I was not disappointed whatsoever. The luminance of the HDR combined with that super sharp 3840 by 2160 16:9 aspect ratio makes for an amazing picture. The HDR makes movies and gaming come to life, and it has that certain wow factor. Like, if you want to get a monitor that you want to show off to your family and friends, be like, look, this is my new toy, this is the monitor to get, because it does that and then some. I was watching some Netflix movies that support 4K and HDR, and it was like night and day coming from my 1440p ultra wide. I never knew. Why didn't you guys tell me? Is this some sort of sick joke? I mean, you guys are supposed to have my back and like look out for me. Why didn't you tell me that this kind of technology was out there? All right. So anyways, guys, I forgive you. Okay. I forgive you. You know, you guys are my peoples. You guys are my homies. I know there has been a lot of issues concerning Windows and HDR, but that seems to be a thing of the past. HDR works great once you turn it on in your display setting. Now, I don't have a PS4 Pro or an Xbox, but this would be the perfect monitor for those systems as well, because they'll be able to take advantage of that HDR and the 4K. This monitor does have FreeSync, which I haven't used an AMD graphics card in years, and I think most people are using Nvidia graphics cards now, but the great news is that now Nvidia has allowed Adaptive Sync to work with FreeSync, so when you turn it on, I definitely notice less screen tearing and more overall smoothness during my high intensity games like Overwatch. My old monitor was 120 hertz, and in the past when I tried to go back down to a 60 hertz monitor like this, it was downright unplayable. But with Adaptive Sync, I can definitely use this monitor for gaming and also get that crisp 4K gaming experience. I think based off of that reason alone, this monitor is worth it over some of the other 4K options. I mean, it is a VA panel, so it's going to look best if you are looking straight on at it. I feel like VA panels are a great in between because you get the quick response times at 4 milliseconds, which is close to a TN panel response time, and TN panels are the best for gaming. But now with VA panels, you get a step up, you get better viewing angles, and you get better colors and blacks like you would on like an IPS system. Display. Now this BenQ monitor has viewing angles up to 178, and while we're on the topic of viewing angles, I feel like this monitor needs a good amount of distance between you and it to get uniform color. So for me personally, I was able to achieve this by just putting it on a monitor arm. So keep that in mind with a VA panel of this screen size, you'll want some distance in between you guys. The screen size, however, makes it a monster for productivity as well. I edit my videos in Premiere, and I never knew how much vertical monitor space I was missing out when I was editing on my 2K monitor, and now I'm able to see so much more vertical space with that 4K monitor and that resolution. It's nice to also just see the footage of these videos in 4K as well. Editing pictures is also awesome because you get so much real estate to edit your pictures, and you can see those fine details of your pictures and like make proper tweaks to them. It's also rocking eye care technology, which takes out some of the blues and has zero flickering. So if you're going to be using this monitor for an extended period of time, it won't kill your eyes. It's the little thing, guys. It's the little things that really make the difference between certain products and other products out there on the market. And I feel like BenQ did a lot of things to make a difference for your overall health. This monitor, while not perfect, does a lot of things right. It's got 4K HDR 10-bit, great color accuracy for video and photo editing. It's got the FreeSync for gaming, and whether you're a PC gamer or a console gamer, this monitor will serve your every need. Alright guys, so that is going to do it for this review. I think I'll be going with this monitor for the time being until I really, really miss that high refresh rate. But until then, this is my new main thing. So thank you for BenQ for sending this monitor out. All the opinions voiced in this video are my own, and I only recommend products I would actually use myself. So no fear guys, BT has your back always. So that being said, it has been your boy BT. Don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.